Are you kidding me? Come over here so I can kick you. That's right, you stupid lizard. Greetings, and welcome to LGR Oddware, where we're taking a look at hardware and software that is odd, forgotten, and obsolete. And today's thing is definitely all three of those, but it is also definitely not all three of those, and that's odd. And of course, we are talking about the Big Keys keyboard. Oh my. So just what are we looking at here? Well, as I said, this is known as the Big Keys keyboard, and it's by a company called Greystone Digital Incorporated. And they were actually founded in 1994 in Huntersville, North Carolina. And that's interesting because that is my home state. And I think this is actually the first thing I've covered on LGR from my state. And of course, it's a piece of oddware. Go figure. And what is this? Well, it's a specialized keyboard for a very specialized purpose. This one in particular is made for very young children to learn the ABCs and such. Hence the crazy color scheme and the fact that this is not actually a QWERTY keyboard, but is an ABCDEF keyboard. So everything is completely out of order and weird. But they also make a lot of other keyboards, but all of them have these big keys. These are actually all 1 inch in diameter. The main demographics for these keyboards, of course, include young children, but also visually and physically limited adults, seniors, commercial users with, people that like wear gloves and stuff, like assembly line workers that, you know, have big clunky sausage fingers because of that, or people with sausage fingers in general, like athletes or giants. Like, seriously, they mention this stuff on their website. It's kind of great. These things weren't cheap, and they still aren't cheap. This one, from what I gather, cost around $150 when it was new, and I think this one actually came out in 1995. From the manufacturing information that I found about this. But they actually still make these things. This was followed up with the Plus version of the keyboard that included more punctuation keys and other like function keys and things like that. And there was also an LX model, which is the latest and greatest and more expensive of these Big Keys keyboards. And they have things like USB support and all that kind of stuff. But this one right here, as far as I can tell, was their very first model of Big Keys keyboard. And, it's really simple stuff. There's nothing really strange going on here. It's just a keyboard on the back. There's no ports or anything like that. And in fact, that's kind of odd, too, because if you see this here, you'll notice that this, and the option key, this is actually a Macintosh-compatible keyboard. These came in PC and Macintosh variations, so this one, being a mid-90s Macintosh product, used ADB to connect, and, if you know anything about Macintosh keyboards, you'll know that the mouse actually plugs into the keyboard, and there's no port on the keyboard for that, so the port is actually right here on the back of the ADB plug, and, again, if you know anything about Macintosh stuff, then you'll know that typically, here's just your standard ADB mouse from the time. That's as long as the cord is. It's just barely longer than the keyboard itself. Honestly, I wish I had an ADB extension cord because, I'll show you in a bit why this shortness is a problem and why plugging it here makes no frickin' sense. Beyond that, though, I mean, there's not much to really talk about. I'm going to show some of the internals here in a little bit because there's one or two interesting things in there. Later versions of this keyboard actually have the ability to swap out these keys. This one you could maybe, swap it over and rearrange these things to spell out QWERTY if you didn't want to do the ABC thing anymore. But unfortunately, this one, it just has an empty spot where there's supposed to be a switch to make the output of this keyboard go from ABC to QWERTY. So this one is in ABC mode permanently unless you just redo it in software or something. And of course, I just gotta touch on it real quick. Why in the world is this thing in an ABC layout instead of QWERTY or even Dvorak or something? Here's the thing. Apparently there are some studies that show that this ABC-like logical kind of in-order format for these letters actually helps very young children, like age 2 to 6, learn the alphabet better before they actually get to figuring out anything about, proper keyboard layout and home keys or anything. Obviously, there's no home keys here, and the keys aren't staggered. They're just in a neat little row, and they have all these colors. This is made for really young kids to just kind of get an idea of a keyboard. This was not the first keyboard to do this, though. There was also the Jim Henson's Muppets Learning Keys keyboard, which did a very similar thing for 8-bit computers in the 80s, and it had even more stuff going on for specific programs and things like that. But yeah, this one here is one that really did the whole idea of looking like an actual keyboard, you know, that adults use. And it would also give kids the ability to figure out their ABCs and stuff like that. And apparently it also works very well with the mentally and developmentally disabled of all kinds. I've heard from people that were in such classes and really got a lot out of using these kind of keyboards just with the regular layout. And one last thing here before we demonstrate its usage, let's go ahead and take a look at the insides, although there's really not much to see. Your typical keyboard controller chips and things like that. There would be a switch there, like I said earlier, to switch to QWERTY mode, but we don't have that. There's no LEDs. There's really not much on here at all. One thing that is interesting, though, is that these keys are actually not only very easily switchable, but they actually have mechanical switches underneath. It's not rubber domed or anything like that, and that's something I did not expect. Although it's pretty much impossible to type efficiently with this thing unless you just completely relearn everything. These actually have very nice switches underneath, and that's pretty cool. Well, I'd say that's enough technical and historical rambling. Let's go ahead and plug this thing into my Macintosh, one of them, and see how it actually functions. All right, we've got the Macintosh up and running here with good old flying toasters going in the background, as well as the keyboard plugged in and ready to go, such as it is. So yeah, it really kind of works just as a normal keyboard. And there you go, that's the demonstration. Other than this being all out of place and missing some keys, it's really just a keyboard. If you're trying to learn home keys or anything, obviously this is not the keyboard for you, but for those other reasons that I listed earlier, I guess this makes sense for some certain situations. And, but yeah, I mean, just even typing something basic, like, I'll just type in the word basic, B-A-S-I-C, and it takes that long, because I don't know where anything is. Also, yeah, this space bar has some problems. You can press it in, and it'll just, yeah, you can see the space just keeps on going. But I'm assuming that's just because this thing is old and not because it's a pile of junk. Because otherwise, these keys actually have a nice click to them. I like these keys. They're too big to be really useful. And of course, everything's all out of order. But, you know, it is what it is. And it takes an absolute age to type anything. Yay. Well, that's pretty much it as far as all of this goes. Typing is typing. However, there is one other thing that we can try here, and that is a game with this type of keyboard. And we are actually going to check out Duke Nukem 3D Atomic Edition for the Macintosh. Because why not? You might notice I'm actually just holding up the keyboard here because I don't have anything to set it on, but it really doesn't matter because this is just not easy no matter what I'm setting this thing on. So I may as well just make it as ridiculous as possible. So let's try to get through E1M1 with this keyboard. Okay, so if I wanted to, I actually could just use like the normal kind of arrow key control setup here. And you know, that's not the most undoable thing, but we're gonna go the full Monty here. And I've actually set it up to use your more typical modern-ish FPS style controls, WASD, because let's make this difficult and get through E1M1 without the arrow keys or anything like that. So let's see. We got A to go forward. Let's see, caps lock, run, A, D is over. No, that's strafe. Crap. Yeah, that is right. Oh crap. I will need turn. Never mind, I guess I do need that. What shoot? You know, I guess I could use the mouse, but, because the mouse cord is so short, it's all the frickin' way over there. I literally have to, like... Oh, I can click it over... Let's see. Yeah, that worked. Okay. A. Turning. Let's just make a run for it. Get out of here. Gotta get out of here. This is actually working a tiny bit better than I anticipated. Oh, crap. Ah! Gotta find a mouse! Okay. A. Space? No. E. Should do that. Come on! I got keyboards of steel. Where, A. E. Oh, no! Oh, yeah. Man, it'd be a lot easier if that mouse were nearby, but, you know, that's what they get for putting the connector on the back of the keyboard connector instead of the keyboard itself, like any other sensible Macintosh product. Get out of here! Ugh. Okay. I gotta go up here, and... Man, why did I have to do this on Damn I'm Good? No, I didn't do it on Damn I'm Good. It feels like it, doesn't it? Oh. No, no, no! No! Don't die! I'm doing this on Let's Rock. Oh! No, 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 no! Oh. I'm pressing space. Press. I guess it's E because it doesn't realize that I've changed anything. Wow, I really should have mapped something to shoot. None of this shoots, does it? And the reason I didn't think to do that is because typically on the PC version you have... you just press control, and none of these do that. So that's great. I don't even have a quick kick or anything, do I? Oh, wonderful. Not only that, but because there's no escape key, I can't actually go back to the menu and change it. Okay, we're gonna give this one more shot. Run mode. E is over there. Get out of the way!
I got this. Doing good.
Oh, mouse is over there. All right. We got this. No. Okay. If I can just get over there and get that atomic health. Okay. Jump. Yeah. Okay. No. Die. Why the mouse got to be so far away? That's right. Whatever, man. Oh, crap. There's more. I will kick you to death. Okay.
I got this.
Jumping out of here. No, do I need to jump out? I just need to get back. Get back this way. Go back this way. Health in there. Okay. What's back? Crap. D, no. S. Where's S? There it is. No! Are you kidding me? Come over here so I can kick you! That's right, you stupid lizard. Okay. No. I got this. No, don't have it! They're gonna kill me! Oh, well... That would have been a little easier if I didn't have to go over there to the mouse, but like I said, it's... The way I have this set up is the computer is, like, over there. And this cable is long enough that, you know, the... If only the mouse plugged in here! Like every other Macintosh keyboard I've ever used. Anyway, that is the Big Keys keyboard. It does not work very well for shooters. It doesn't work very well for typing. It's missing any of the useful keys, you know, like escape. No function keys, no numpad. It's useless except for its original intended purpose, and I guess I can't fault it for that. And at least it has an interesting color scheme, and by that I mean it looks like a clown vomited everywhere, but that's okay.
And if you'd care to see any more Oddware or just videos on things that I find intriguing, why not click some of these or subscribe, because I do videos every week. I have for a long time now. I'm gonna keep doing them too. And you can always bother me on Twitter, Facebook, or even Patreon. And as always, thank you for watching.